Hey guys, it's gabavr, and this time I share a fast and easy 360 video editing tip, or actually a 360 reframing tip, without having to use any third party apps on smartphone. If you shoot with an Insta360 camera, now you can find a cool feature in the app, and I show you how it works. Let's say you've recorded a simple clip and you want to get something spectacular out of it and share it on social media as soon as possible, or save it for later editing. So far you could edit your footage by tracking some selected subjects or using your phone's gyroscope to record camera movement. But if you don't want to watch your video over and over again composing your image and thinking about the best solution, or simply you run out of ideas how to turn your clip into something exciting, you can give a chance to AI to make the hardest part for you. After connecting your camera to your phone, you can browse videos directly from your SD card in your camera without having to transfer them. By tapping on the selected video, open the video editor, where among others you can select the aspect ratio of the output video. Now let's switch to 16:9. As you can see, there are three options on the top menu. The default one is called Edit, which is the editor where you can select key subjects in the video for auto-tracking. While the middle one, called Snap, is the gyroscope editor, and the auto option on the right side will be auto-frame, using AI to create a spectacular video with various framing and camera moves. Tapping on AI Analysis in the middle of the screen, we can start analyzing the video. During processing, you can see all the drafts with key movements and subjects generated by AI. After the analysis is done and all the drafts are created, several options appear under the video preview. Tapping on Compilation, we find longer clips with all the camera movements and speed ramping created by AI. We don't have to think about reframing and spend time with tracking multiple subjects in the video. We get a fully edited clip instead, generated totally automatically. And it's quite surprising how AI could guess my intention, for example in creating this movement, which I was exactly thinking about during shooting. But as I mentioned, besides compilation we can find further views here, like selfie, forward, others, and all the drafts. They can be shorter or longer clips, all collected in dedicated folders. These drafts may contain even the same parts of the video, but in different framing or with different camera moves. And besides exporting the compilation video, we can also export any of these drafts too, or use them in further editing. And here comes another option if we want to create our final cut manually, but using the scenes generated by AI. Here I can tap the single drafts one by one and crop the best parts of them. And then I can select these clips and add them to a timeline for a final cut. So instead of exporting to the phone album, I tap on Create Story. In this case I work with 4 different clips, which I could delete even at this point, but I can also change the order of them by pushing and moving the clips or add some transitions between them. Then finally I can export this edited video too. Just like in most of the cases, I select custom exporting settings with the highest resolution and bitrate available. And as a final step, I can save this video on my smartphone or share it on social media. So if you're looking for a cool reframe video made of your 360 raw material quickly and easily, now you can use AutoFrame with a fully AI-generated solution, or you can go through a short editing process right on your smartphone and you'll get a little bit more customized version of the final clip. Anyhow, if you found these tips useful, hit the like button, write your questions in the comment section, and for further 360 contents and tutorials, subscribe to my channel, and see you next time!